Reports from the Ministry of Water and Environment show that only 17% of Ugandans have access to safe and clean water in their homes, and the majority have to walk long distances to access this clean water. Dr. Callist Tindi Mugaya, the Commissioner for Water Resources in the Ministry of Water and Environment, notes that 51% of the water bodies in Uganda have good water quality, but only 4% of the wastewater is treated. But a lot of water is being discharged without being treated.
We are talking about 17% of Ugandans have access to safe water in their premises. In sanitation, we are talking about 8.1%. In the terms of water quality, about 51% of the water bodies have good water quality. About 4% of wastewater is actually being treated. A lot of it is being discharged when it is not treated.
Tindi Mugaya admits that Uganda still lags behind in terms of access to clean and safe water and has a long way to go in terms of attaining the Sustainable Development Goal 6. This is attributed to the fact that the government still allocates limited resources to water, sanitation and hygiene facilities.
For example, before SDGs came into place, we were reporting water supply coverage and sanitation along the walking distance or how many people are accessing the water. Right now in urban areas we have 72% of the people having access to safe drinking water and 67% in rural areas. But when it comes to SDG basically says you need to have water in the people's compound. And these people have to be safe, free from any contamination. In Uganda, very few people have actually water in their compounds. Many people have to walk.
A network that coordinates all the civil society organizations that work in the sanitation and environment partners to deliberate and see how far we are with attaining SDG 6. Statistics have been shared, and I'll just mention a few. The fact that out of every 10 households, only seven households have access to clean water.
According to Yunia Musazi, the executive director of UWASNET, a civil society organization on water and sanitation advocacy, the required annual investment within water, sanitation and environment programs is an average of around 7 trillion shillings, but the sector only receives 1.5 trillion shillings from the government. She calls for enhanced funding of the sector's unfunded priorities.
So what we're here to do is that, yes, like we've heard from the commissioner, the required annual investment within the water, sanitation and environment programs is an average of around, 7 trillion? But we get, as a sector, we get around 1.5 trillion. So in spite of the CSOs contributing, what we are contributing is not enough.
Meanwhile, Alfred Okot Okidi, the permanent secretary in the Ministry of Water and Environment, urged members of UWASNET to always report to the government what they are doing as part of good governance. He said that currently only 50% of the members have reported to the government, which affects national and global reporting and acquisition of data.
Urge the members of UWASNET to ensure that you become more active and participate effectively. When I hear that only 50% of the members have reported, it affects the overall national and global reporting of what is happening in the country. Data is important. Reporting.
Rachel Nachuala, reporting for the news.